If you remember, last week, the sanctuary looked so different, and a group of us got together because we had the job of undecorating. And it certainly looks different, doesn't it? And we all come in a little disappointed. But I want to read something to you from a very beautiful Christmas card. I just want to share this with you. It isn't pine and holly that makes it Christmas Day. It isn't all the tinsel or the gifts that we give away. It isn't glowing candles that flicker in the night. It isn't lighted Christmas trees that make the season bright. What really makes it Christmas is the hope Christ came to bring. The peace on earth, goodwill to men, of which the angels sing. So may you know the love and peace of feeling Jesus near, keeping Christmas in your heart each day throughout the year. Now, doesn't that make us feel better that the sanctuary seems somewhat empty?
Yes.
I have something else, and I'm going to tell you it's a little different. We all know that prayer is not only talking to God, but it's listening to God. And today, I'm going to share with you, it's from a devotional journal by Sarah Young called Jesus Calling. Come to me with a teachable spirit, eager to be changed. A close walk with me is a life of continual newness. Do not cling to the old ways as you step into a new year. Instead, seek my face with an open mind, knowing that your journey with me involves being transformed by the renewing of your mind. As you focus your thoughts on me, be aware that I am fully attentive to you. I see you with a steady eye because my attention span is infinite. I know and understand you completely. My thoughts embrace you in everlasting love. I also know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Give yourself fully to this adventure of increasing attention, attentiveness to my presence. Talk with me about your struggles and feelings of inadequacy. Little by little, I will transform your weaknesses into strengths. Remember that your relationship with me is saturated in grace. Therefore, nothing that you do or don't do can ever separate you from my presence. May we be blessed as we listen to your voice. Amen. And one thing, we did have a request for prayer for Kenneth Wilson, who passed away on Friday. So keep him in your prayers, but keep listening to God talk.